So if salvia experiences can be so bad so often, and they really can be, especially for beginners, not so much once you do it for a while, why would you mess around with this stuff at all, right? Well, here's the thing. It's called a dissociative. It's the only drug that is given that label. And what that means is that you still see everything that you see ordinarily and experience everything that you ordinarily experience, but you don't identify with them. You don't identify, you don't see, just take it for granted that you are your body or that you are your thoughts or that you are your emotions. Instead, you take all of this stuff and you basically see them as data, pieces of data just streaming through your experiences, like frames in a movie. And even really negative emotions, because you're not associated with them, you just see them for what they are and accept them for what they are. I think of salvia as very disorienting, which, and disorientation we usually think as, negative. But you're so disoriented towards what the hell is going on. It's almost like you're an infant. Like you just were born and you don't have the labels and you don't have the assumptions. You don't know who you are or what's going on. All you have is your raw experience right now. And so you have this incredibly sort of objective perspective on your own life. And if you harness it right, this perspective can be a great source of wisdom and creativity and emotional healing. Of course, it might not work for you that the first time, and you kind of have to figure out how to do it. I've been doing it for a really long time and have cultivated this relationship with the herb. And that's why I'm making this video series. The next one will be plain and simple: how do you smoke salvia?